Hello children, today we will learn about topic fiber to fabric, classic subject science. So before that I want to have some recap of whatever knowledge you have about the clothes. No? So in your lower classes you have studied what are the basic needs in our life. What are the basic needs in our life? Food, clothing and shelter. No? So in that three, one of it also it is not there. We cannot live. We cannot survive. Okay. So today only about the clothing we will learn in detail. Okay. So by the end of the lesson, you will be knowing about history of clothing material. What do you mean by fiber and fabric? What are the different types of fibers? In that types of fibers, you will be learning in detail about natural and man-made fibers, how it is processed, how it is done. So by the end of the lesson, you will be learning about this. Okay, next. So now first, I want to take about the history of clothing material. Okay, so in this history of clothing material, did you ever think what did early humans they used to wear? They used to cover their bodies with leaves, dry twigs, skin of dead animals. Like this only it happened long, many, many years ago. Then the civilization started, then they have learned many, many things. Slowly they came to know how to wear the stitched clothes like we are wearing. So what happened means before 40,000 years ago, 40,000 years ago, at that time, needle was invented. So when the needle was invented, then they have invented sewing machine, then clothing has been started. Means with the help, they started stitching the clothes by using the machine. Okay. Then in the 19th century, the clothing of with cotton has become very, very famous. Okay. So then all over the world also, cotton, which I am wearing now, the cotton fabric, it has become very famous. Okay, next. After today's history of clothing material, now we will go in detail about the fiber to fabric. Already you know, what do you mean by fiber? Fiber is nothing but thin hair-like structure. Very, very thin, very thin hair-like thread is called as fiber. So, from the fiber, we are getting fabric. In detail, I'll explain that, you don't worry. Okay, next. What are the different types of fibers we will get? Actually, where do these fibers we will get? We get fibers either from natural or else from man-made. Okay, so that, what do you mean by natural? That we will see. So natural fibers we will be getting either from plants or else animals, both. Okay, so we will get fibers from plants and animal. Okay, so from that two sources, if we are getting such kind of fibers are called as natural fibers. If the fibers are made from chemicals, then they are called as man-made fibers. Okay, did you get my point? The fibers that we obtain from plants and animals are called as natural fibers. The fibers that we are making it from chemicals are called as man-made fibers. Okay, now we will see about what are the plant fibers. Okay, now see here, I have written the different plants. Okay, so what are the different plants I have taken, that I will tell you. See here, plant fibers. So what are the different plant fibers we are getting? First we will see cotton. I have taken cotton, we will get it from cotton plants. Okay, well, from where we will be getting? From cotton fruit. These words you have to remember, which part is getting what. Okay, from the cotton fruit you will be getting cotton fiber. Okay, like that you will be getting it another fiber called as hemp. Hemp we will get it from the stem of hemp plant. Okay, flax. Flax we will get it from flax plant. Okay, next, sisal. We will get it from leaves of sisal plant. Next, silk cotton. We will get it again from fruits of silk cotton. Okay. Next, jute, we will get it from jute plant. Okay. So these are the 7 types of plant fibers. We are getting it from different plants, either from stem or else from fruits or else from leaves. You have to remember. Okay, from fruits means cotton and silk cotton. Leaves means sisal, you have to remember. And remaining we will be getting it from stem. Apart from that, sorry, I didn't tell you about the coir. Coir we will get it from coconut. When you will observe a coconut, outside of the coconut fruit, you will be observing thick fiber. That fiber is nothing but it is called as coir. So what is the use of coir? Coir is used to make ropes and as well as door mats. Am I clear here about the plant fibers? Okay. Now in detail, just now I told you about cotton, different fibers. In that different fibers, we will see in detail about cotton and jute. That only we will see now in detail very much. Okay, next. Cotton. Where do we get cotton fiber? Cotton fiber, we will get it from cotton fruits. That cotton fruits are called as cotton balls. Check, what did I write there? Spelling on the board. What I wrote? Cotton balls. B-O-L-L-S. Balls. Okay. So from the cotton balls we are getting cotton fiber. Okay. So what you have, what is observed means when the cotton plant, it gives flowers. After the flowering stage, the flowers will be changing to fruits. You can see the cotton plant if you are having near your homes. When the cotton fruit, it opens, it bursts. At that time, you can see all the 4 to 5 parts opened and you can see the bunches of fiber there, cotton fiber. If you take the cotton fiber from that, you can see the seeds inside that. So the seeds will be removed very, very slowly. We can remove the seeds. Apart from that, so for making the fabric, that cotton, it will be taken out or it will be separated from the cotton seeds with the help of a structure, comb-like structure, sorry. With the help of a comb-like structure. You can see the comb, like comb-like structure. They will be keeping the cotton fiber there and they will be pulling. So when they are pulling, no, the cotton seeds will be separated from the cotton fabric. So from the cotton fabric, the seeds will be separated. This process of separating cotton fiber from cotton seeds is called as skimming. These words are very, 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 very important. Okay, skimming. G-I-N-N-I-N-G. Skimming. So, skimming is the process where it is used to separate cotton fiber from cotton seeds. Okay, so this is all. So, then the cotton fiber is obtained. After obtaining the cotton fiber, I'll explain what will be done, how it will be made into yarn, that I'll tell you after. Okay, so in this plant fiber, we will be learning about detail about cotton fiber and as well as jute fiber. So cotton, I have explained now. Cotton is obtained from cotton fruit by the help of skimming. Am I clear? Okay, next. Now we will see about jute. So how is jute obtained? Jute is obtained from the stem of jute plant. Now I want to add some points about the jute. Okay, first, jute plants, where do they grow? They will grow in alluvial soil. These words are very, very important. Alluvial soil. Okay, what do you mean by this alluvial soil? Means it is nothing but they will be having maximum rainfall. Maximum rainfall you will be finding here. Okay, maximum rainfall will be there. So that plants you will be finding near the Brahmaputra area. Okay, near the Brahmaputra Ganges. Okay, so what happens when the jute plants are grown? When they will be reaching a flowering stage. At the flowering, during the flowering stage, all the stems, they will be pulled out. They will be separated from the roots. Means they will be removed from the roots. So some stems and roots will be separated. So when the stems are separated from the roots, then the stems will be soaked in water like this. When they are soaked in water, all the water in the water, they will be dipping. They will be soaking it. So they will leave it for some time. Then afterwards, when the soaking is done, then the stems get separated from the fibers. Okay. So this process of soaking jute plants in water is called as ripping. What it is called? Rip. So these are the two fibers which we have dealt in detail about obtaining the fibers. Thank you. So in the next recording, I'll explain in detail how the fiber is made into fabric or piece of cloth. Okay, thank you.